Oh, I'm sorry. You know what? You go ahead. I didn't realize.
I didn't even realize that you were trying to get by at the same time.
You know what? It's my fault. I didn't tell you which way I was going.
Oh.
So, you know what? You go ahead. Go ahead, sir.
I must insist, I was taking very close track of everything that happened here today, and I do know for a fact you were here first.
I was here.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, it's just a gentlemanly thing to do. Let you go.
That's
on
very
by.
Nice
yeah.
of you. Okay, I'll yeah. go. Thank okay. you very much. Oh, okay. So no, I'll just.
No. Oh,
look at us. Hey. Okay. All right. You go that way. I'll go this way. We'll meet around the middle. We'll call it a day. Okay.
All right.
Okay. Go
Sounds
ahead.
Like we got all it right. figured.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
We'll take care.
Yeah. Salutations.
Nice meeting you and stuff.
Yeah. All the best.
Wow. All right. Take care. What a great guy. Wow. Wow.
Live from Hamilton, Ontario, this is Anytime with Eric Johnston. On today's show, voice actor Christian Potenza. With him as always, the Rhythm Express. And now, your host, Eric Johnston.
Guys, how's it going? Welcome to Anytime with Eric Johnston. I'm your host, Eric Johnston, and you guys are welcome anytime. Thank you so much. Thank you. Let's give it up for the house band Rhythm Express, everybody. I'm excited. I've never really had my own band. You know, I'm excited about kind of the powers I have of having my own band. Actually, talking to the drummer over there, could you give me one of those kind of comedic, you know? Exactly. That's perfect. I don't need it right now. Just, you know, kind of hold on to it. Keep it in your pocket, and we'll use it later, okay? Thanks. Actually, I want to take this time to talk about something that's kind of very important to me. I want to take this time to talk about global warming and climate change and how it's affecting us as a humanity. No. Okay. No, that's good. Thank you. I mean, that's great work, but I just want to do something serious, you know, to the camera. Great. Thank you. Climate change is affecting the polar ice caps, which is causing sea levels to rise every single day, and we're not sure what's going to happen to us as a humanity. Okay. That's good. Like I said, trying to have, you know what, a serious moment with the camera. Thank you. Millions of species of plants and animals are dying every single day, and some are tragically even becoming extinct. Okay. You know, not a lot of people have a platform like I do. I'm trying to have a serious moment to the camera here, okay? Please, just let me kind of have this moment. Our ozone layer is burning up, and harmful rays from the sun are coming through and affecting the lives of our friends and families. Okay. You know, you want to do jokes? Okay, let's do jokes. Okay, fine, I'll do jokes. You know, harmful rays are coming through the ozone layer, and they're burning up everybody, but the good news is, people in Ireland can finally get a tan. You're not gonna do the thing? Obviously, we have some figuring out to do, but we'll be back after this on Anytime with Eric Johnston. Give it up for Rhythm Express. Yes! Give it up, keep it going for Rhythm Express. Amazing, amazing house band. The drummer and I still have some work to do. Our guest today on Anytime with Eric Johnston is Christian Potenza. Christian Potenza is an actor, a voice actor. Most importantly, he's a good friend of mine. If you don't know who Christian is, check him out right here.
this! It's a gingerbread cheerleader that looks like my girlfriend, Cherry. Go ahead, enjoy.
It's a condition of my parole, except for the hurt part, eh? That's all, McLean.
You spent some change, love. You scratch each other's back and all that, then.
I'm gonna go build a small car out of rocks, or maybe teach a cow to give me some milk. I will hug him, and I will corrupt him, and I will rename him Mephistopheles.
You saw him there, and you'll see him here today on Anytime with Eric Johnston. His name is Christian Potenza. Please give a warm welcome to Christian Potenza!
Wow.
Swag!
Hey, buddy.
See you, man.
He's here! Yes! Comfy, cozy.
This is really comfy. It just got real in here.
It got so real. Christian Potenza's here, guys. Give it up for him. Anytime with Eric Johnston.
Go on.
Now, we are very good friends.
Yeah.
You and I, very good friends.
I would say that, but you...
Let's just
leave it at very. You don't have to double up on the very.
Very, very good friends.
Okay, we're very, very good friends.
So that's all I can hope for. See, we got it on camera. I'm using it on my demo reel. But you do so much, and it's hard, you know. I don't see you so often because you're doing so many things. You've done so many different cartoons, and tell us about all the things.
Well, you know, you can usually spot my voice out, you know. I was the voice of Coco, the Fido dog, and the guy, the Wendy's guy, the late night guy.
Okay,
right?
That
and
makes sense.
People, like, they go, I know that guy. That's you, isn't it? I'm like, yeah, pretty much. Like, all the major cartoons I do, it's just me talking like this.
So you do Sidekick, 16, Total Drama. Now that I think
Almost Naked Animals.
Oh, Dirk Danger and Almost Naked Animals.
That one you wouldn't know it was me.
Yeah.
Because it's
danger. I can't see.
Actually, you know what? I've done a lot of voices on a lot of big cartoons, you know,
okay.
and stuff. And I've got the most interesting voice gig right now going on. Have you ever heard of So So Happy?
So So Happy.
Have you ever heard of So So Happy?
Round of applause. Have you heard of So So Happy?
Okay.
They got a very polite couple nods. Yeah.
Yeah. Think, yeah. Exactly.
I think we have heard of that. I don't want to make too much noise.
It's this little thing. It's like this clothing line or merch thing where they've got these little characters, and so now they're making a cartoon. So they've hired a bunch of voice actors, well-known voice actors, but we don't actually say anything.
Don't say anything.
No, there's these little 2-3 minute little clips of. People are of these little characters interacting, and so for 2 hours I'm in the booth. I got hired because I'm like, well, you're Christian Potenza, you're that guy, you know. I didn't get hired for a voice quality because I don't say anything. It's just me for 2 hours going ooh,
that's it. Wow.
I know.
How do I get that gig? I guess I'm not Christian Potenza.
Did you just try to do my voice?
No, that was
doing
more
my
like
name?
Weird announcer voice that I tried to do. I don't know. But you've done, not only done that, but like tell us about the process for Total Drama, 16, Sidekick.
Oh. Well, yeah, I mean, I couldn't get arrested in the voice world. And I moved back from California. I was there for a couple years. And when I came back, I sort of found my hit, my brand. And that was 12, you know, like teenage boys, skater dudes.
Skater dudes, okay.
So when I came back, I got an audition for a cartoon called Sidekick, and they said, his name's Trevor Troublemeyer, and he's a bratty 12-year-old. So I talk like this. And then I got another audition for a, because I got the job, right? And then they were like, oh, this guy's awesome. So bring him in for this cartoon called 16. You're playing a character called Jude Lizowski, and he's a chilled out skater dude. So I talk like this.
Pretty similar, okay.
Got the job. And then a couple years later, they're like, you know what? We want you to go out for this thing called Total Drama. And he's kind of like Ashton Kutcher meets Jeff Probst. You know, he's like an older 30-year-old guy. So I talk like this. One voice, 3 paychecks. Nailed it! Yeah. Well, nailed it!
That's the dream. We got so much more to talk about with Christian Potenza. We'll be back right after this, guys.
Listen, Eric. It's not that I don't like you. You're a fun guy. You're a really great friend. I just don't see us in a relationship.
It's my face, isn't it?
No. It's more that...
Is it the looming and lurking in the shadows?
You know, that really doesn't help.
I'll turn a light on.
It's just... I don't know what you can offer me.
Offer you? Offer you? I mean, take a look at my resume. I can sing. I'm a composer. I can play the organ. I know a little bit of magic. I got my own place. You can see the opera whenever you want. I mean, you got the best seat of the house. I mean, and good luck finding a guy who's got his own gondola.
Well, the gondola rides were lovely. Don't get me wrong.
Yeah, but you know what? Okay, all right. I know what this is about. It's okay. I know what it is. You want me to write you another song. Okay, here we go. I love...
All right, enough. It is your face.
I knew it! You know what? You ought to be ashamed of yourself. You and all your other full-face friends. I mean, I've got a nose, I've got a mouth. When I put the mask on, you can't even really tell the difference. I mean, I could see if I was missing a limb or something, if I was the amputee of the opera, but I just don't get this, you know?
Who ordered the open face melt?
We are back on Anytime with Eric Johnston. Now, when you came out here, you threw this shirt to me. It's a mint green, and it's actually, I realized, it's Jude's shirt.
It's Jude's shirt, because I do all these conventions and these Comic-Cons and stuff, and I started this little thing on the sleeve.
Okay.
It's a little patch. It's like a microphone that looks like a grenade, and it says the Animation Nation Army. Because I started doing these conventions and, because of Facebook, it wasn't around when I first started doing cartoons. And then all of a sudden, because of Facebook, these fans were getting in touch with me. And by the end of it, I started up a YouTube channel and I had like 12,000 subscribers and like 5,000 friends on Facebook, 4,000. So it was just like I had an army of all these kids who wanted to be voice actors and they wanted to be animators and they just love cartoons. So my agent was like, you kind of got this like animation army. And I was just like, so it dawned on me. So I started up this thing and I do tours of conventions and Comic-Cons, fan expos.
So at these Comic-Cons and fan expos, do you ever run into any kind of crazy fan, super fans? Like anyone who was like, oh, in episode this, you were this, and then episode that, you were that.
No, those kind of people don't show up to those kind of events at all.
So you've met.
No, this is the Super Bowl. Like, these people save up their money and build their costumes to come out and meet their fans.
Okay.
And they get one shot a year. Yeah, no, some of these people are just so, they are true, true fans because they know everything, exactly what you said. Yeah. You know, they're like, in episode 3, you mentioned that you were allergic to bananas, but yet... In season 5, episode 8, you ate a peanut butter and banana sandwich. What's the deal? And I was like, dude, I don't know. I don't even read the scripts, man. I just show up and rock the mic. No, but they're great. They are a colorful bunch.
And by being there, you're actually making a couple dreams come true.
Yeah, you know, I see a lot of people. Like, there was this one guy, he showed up and he was wearing like contacts and wig and makeup and prosthetic fangs, and he had this big sword.
A real sword?
A real sword, man. Like,
that's dangerous.
This is the only place I know where like you can have 30,000 people walking around carrying weapons and nothing
like,
happens.
Yeah, that's just Bradley.
Yeah, totally. That's his thing. He's the sword
he's
guy.
He's the sword guy.
But he's standing there going, do you know who I am? And I was like, no idea, bro. Just met you. And he goes, I'm doing a crossplay cosplay, and he goes, I'm Yugi Magi from da da da, and this, I know nothing about anime at all.
Okay.
So he's just looking like total Jim Henson nightmare in front of me, and but we start talking, and he's followed me from like since he was like 8 years old, right? And this is like now the guy's like 20, you know, and grown up ish. I don't know. I never saw his face, but he's standing there in this costume at just like live puppet and going, just want to let you know that you had a big part in who I am today. And I was like, yeah. I am so happy I could help out with that, Yugi-Go-Guy Master G. Yeah.
Christian Potenza making dreams come true for cosplay, guys. Let's give that up.
Yeah.
Yeah. Now, backstage, we were talking, and you said that you had a dream or a goal or something. I don't know much about it. He just kind of said that, you know, he wanted to.
When you called and told me that, you know, hey, man, I want you on my show. I got this going on. I got a band. I got, like, you know.
We got Rhythm Express.
Rhythm Express, man. They're awesome. And then I was thinking, that's great. You're living the dream. And I want to get on the coattails of that. And I want to live out a little dream of mine. And that is to play trumpet with a full-on band. You know what I mean?
Yeah, that's... You guys seem excited. He's excited. I don't have a trumpet to get. They don't have a trumpet. There's no horns.
I come prepared. I brought my own.
Okay. You brought your own trumpet.
Yeah.
Okay.
Check it out.
He brought his own trumpet. All right. Well, that's convenient for him and this show.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Well, it's got real.
Show him what you got, guys, I guess. You guys can figure it out.
All right.
Okay,
just got real, buddy. Let's
see what he's got. Water. That's good. That's good? All right, I think he's okay. One more time for Christian Potenza. Guys, my name is Eric Johnston. This has been Anytime with Eric Johnston. Let's give it up one more time for Rhythm Express, guys.